Are you okay?
I'm pretty sure the guy in that truck's following me.
He's road raging.
Why don't you just chill, man? Go your own way.
I don't think you really know what a bad day is.
But you're gonna find out.
That man stole my phone. Andy?
I'm sitting here. I'm waiting for you.
Whose phone is this?
I'm right across from your friend.
Hey, listen to me. He's not a friend, okay? He's a psycho who came after me today.
This is where your first lesson begins.
Give me my phone.
Put him back on this goddamn phone!
No, I can't do that.
What do you want?
I need you to learn what a bad day really is. I need you to learn how to see.
Aloha! This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, coming to you live once again from beautiful Hawaii here on the island of Oahu, bringing you, yes you, the best movie reviews on the entire island of Oahu. And yes, this is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man. And yes, today I am talking to you about a movie, a real movie, not a Netflix movie, but, you know, although, as we have seen, those have become real movies. But this Friday, opening everywhere in the United States, pretty much, where it can be seen if the theaters aren't open. So no New York, no LA, California, etc. Is the Russell Crowe movie, the first to dive into the waters of the COVID world in new releases. And his movie is called Unhinged. Now, remember our rating scale, shock a thumbs up. It's good to see, I recommend it. Shock a thumbs down, it's bad to see, it's junk. I don't recommend it. And for the new Russell Crowe thriller, it is a shock a thumbs down. Oh my God. If you are waiting for the feel-good movie of the summer, you better just keep on waiting. maybe New Mutants next week. But you don't want to see this movie. You certainly don't want to take your kids to see this movie. It is a solid shock of thumbs down. Now, I was able to go ahead and see a early preview screening of this movie, fortunately, over here in Hawaii. And I got to tell you, I don't know what rock bottom level Russell Crowe has hit in his career, but as far as an Oscar award winning actor, for him to be doing, pretty much an impression of Michael Myers or John Voorhees, you know, from Friday the 13th, that's essentially what he's doing here, playing this psychopathic killer. Right from the opening of the movie, we see his character just literally kill his, we find out his ex-wife, her boyfriend, maybe her husband at this point. We don't know. And right from the get-go, he is on the run from the police due to these murders. We see in a news flash that he is... You know, he is the key suspect, wanted by the police, in association with these murders. Known history of violence, had problems restraining order against his, put against him by his wife, etc. You name it, fired from his job. Before he gets his pension and retires, blah, blah, blah. You know, they try to kind of play it where you can get some sympathy for this guy. But believe me, there's really nothing there to like about this character. They try to show that, anybody can have a bad day. And if you don't know what a bad day is, like it says in the trailer, it can happen to you. He can happen to you. He's going to make it happen to you so that you understand. just what a bad day really is. Who else stars in this movie other than Russell Crowe? I guess newcomer Karen Pistorius, Jimmy Simpson playing her divorce lawyer, Gabriel Bateman, which is her son, and Austin P. McKenzie plays her brother. I guess Gabriel's uncle. We find out that she is going through a divorce as well, having separated from her husband. She has the kid, her brother, and his fiance is staying over at her place. But the husband wants to take her house, and thus that's where Jimmy Simpson, her friend, her best friend, who's also a lawyer, is helping her pro bono for free, in the suit against her husband for the house through this divorce out of the goodness of his heart. She, being under all this stress, is running late, having problems with her job. Apparently, she's a hair salonist or something like that, a beautician maybe. But because, of the stress, she's often running late to her appointments, and she is fired. She's stuck in traffic trying to take her son to school one morning, jumps on the freeway, it's packed, jumps off the freeway, it's packed. Finally, it kind of clears up. Gets behind Russell Crowe's truck, a known truck that was seen leaving the murder of his ex-wife and her boyfriend / possible new husband. And he's just, zooming along, he fails to go at a green light. And so she honks at him, which is the normal, the standard. Nothing outrageous, but he gets upset that it's like, oh, why didn't you just give me like a love tap on the horn? We've all been there. The guy, you're coming out of Makaha Valley, trying to get to work downtown, Waikiki. And, you want to make sure you get that light so you can get out there on H1 and at least, get into that kind of stop and go traffic there. You don't want any further delays. The last thing you want to do is miss your left turn, at the light and be, 20, 30 minutes held up extra because you missed that light, because this guy just didn't, it was a clear green. He was all clear that you could see. She could have went around him. Eventually she does go around him after honking and he still doesn't move. But then she's stuck in traffic, after the turn, maybe a few blocks ahead. And of course, by that time, he finally goes, he catches up with her, and they exchange some heated words, at the next stoplight. Right away, he goes berserk, cuts her off, almost causes an accident with her. And from that moment on, begins to hunt her down through the rest of her life. Somehow, I guess he was following her after she drops off her son from school, although you don't see it. He finds her at a gas station pumping gas. She goes to pay, leaves her car open. He grabs her phone out of the car. She didn't take the phone. She has no password on her phone. And she has everything, her entire life on her phone, which, to be fair, most people do. He clears out her bank account, starts to, hunt through her contact list, gets the addresses to all her friends, family, knows where she lives, etc. And, right away goes, sees her best friend, kills him in a public restaurant, brutally, stabs him, Police, you know, and he walks out calm. Just 2 years ago, we had that crazy over in Cunia that stopped at the light, started trying to stab people. So people came to try to help the person, and you know, they were stabbed, but I think it slowed them up long enough for the police to get there, you know. But that was about it. So, you know, fortunately, I guess, you know, on the good side, he never has a gun. So he, cause, you know, always resorts to these knives, blunt objects. I think he killed his wife with an axe and her boyfriend. That's what it looked like. Maybe a baseball bat thrown in there for good measure, before burning down their entire house. But yeah, so basically that is the plot. And the entire rest of the movie, he is hunting her down, killing off. He goes after her brother, who is staying at his house, kills his girlfriend / fiance, almost kills him. Fortunately, by that time, the police intervene. She's able to call the police and, you know, most likely alert that he could be going after her brother at the house. And you know, he's shot, but still bleeding profusely from the shoulder. He's still able to somewhat calmly, rationally get around and still follow her over to her grandmother's house, where she tries to hide her son and put up some type of defense. Why she didn't go to a police station, you know, the son kind of mentions it, but it's like, oh, you know, they won't be able to help us, is pretty much the answer. Which, you know, the police in this are extremely inept, to say the least. So that's pretty much it. It ends just like a standard slasher film, whereas, you know, the heroine at the end is able to gain the upper hand at mere moments, and, you know, basically thwart the villain, which is Russell Crowe. You know, this looks like a pretty much a one and done. It's clear that there's probably not going to be any sequel from this. This movie was made on a $33 million budget. They completed filming back in, I think, August 2018. It was supposed to come out, oh no, wait, oh, in 2019, I think they finished filming. It was supposed to come out in September of 2020, but due to the pandemic, they said, oh, we will try to get the jump on everybody else, and when the movie theaters open up, we will be the first movie out there. And I have to say, that is brilliant marketing strategy, because people are desperate and hungry to see movies, and that is the only way this movie, you know, has a chance of making its budget back. Any other day, any other normal time of the, you know, the in life, this movie would be one of those straight to videos you find $5 in the bargain bin at Walmart. That is how shock and thumbs down this movie is, Unhinged. It's definitely not worth paying to go see in the theater, let alone risking your life to go see, you know, and possibly get COVID-19. Just stay home and watch it. You know, there are better movies upcoming that, you know, will be more worth the risk. You know, no disparaging remarks about any movie theaters, and they're not cleaning routine. But I mean, if you're afraid at all, do not waste your possible chance of safety on Unhinged. It's not worth it. But yeah, you know, so, you know, but this opened up already in parts of the world, UK, Germany, New Zealand, Australia. It's made approximately $7 million so far, and opens up this Friday, in the United States wherever the movie theaters are open, which is here in Hawaii. So this is the only new movie that's going to be shown at the movie theaters. Basically, all the other movies are going to be like old retreads, maybe Harry Potter, you know, all the classics, basically. You'd be better off seeing one of those movies if you really wanted to go to the movie theater. If not, I highly recommend you to, one, not see this movie at all, or two, just wait till it's on Netflix or HBO or you know, I wouldn't even rent this movie on streaming. I just wait for it to be on normal TV. This is, you know, we hadn't seen a movie like this for a long time, kind of a road rage slasher movie. Not since, I'd say, the 70s. You know, Steven Spielberg started that kind of genre off with Duel, the wonderful classic thriller. With Dennis Weaver as the hero in that movie, threatened by a semi-truck that's just chasing him throughout the highways of America. And, you know, right after that, like all through the 70s, there were these like TV, made-for-TV movies, I guess maybe video at the time, of, you know, crazy, you know, road rage people in cars, you know, just doing whatever they want in their car, killing thousands of people, driving, smashing up, no damage to their car as they're, you know, busting through all these other cars. One in particular sticks out, but I can't remember the name of the movie. It was some crazy, and the line that one of the reporters says, like, yeah, you know, somebody can be like a 90-pound weakling, but they get in their truck or something on the highway, and suddenly they're in their Incredible Hulk, blah, you know, and nothing's going to stop them. And, you know, this movie tries to make some kind of social commentary on the state of, you know, road rage, you know, violence in society. But other than a quick couple of news flashes from modern life, throughout the years, it really fails to give any serious message towards that predicament, that problem in society. And it certainly doesn't offer up any solutions other than taking the law in your own hands. It tries to say, well, you know, just be nice to everybody on the road, you know, show them aloha. You know, and here in Hawaii, we're good at that. But still, you know, things have changed. And with the increase in the cars and the traffic, I mean, even in the COVID, you know, we saw how nice it was with the lockdown, being able to drive on the road and get somewhere in a decent amount of time. And slowly as the state reopened up, we saw that horrendous traffic come back and, you know, moods change, you know, people cutting off people on the highway, not using their signal, honking at them like crazy, yelling at them, flipping them off, you know, you name it. You know, it happens. You know, but I mean, you know, if you're on your phone, you know, and as the heroine is several times, as the villain in this movie is several times, you know, don't be on your phone, you know, use that hands-free function at least, you know, because, yeah, somebody's going to honk at you, you know, you're not paying attention to the light, the road, or you're just going to slam into somebody by accident, or, you know, it's going to increase the road rage, you know, try to stay calm and carry on, essentially. But, you know, you'll probably be able to do that much better if you skip Unhinged. I'm really surprised Russell Crowe decided to make a movie like this and play this type of role. I mean, maybe it plays towards his personality. We've heard of him getting some of that aggression, that anger, where he's become unhinged. Cinderella Man was a famous incident where in an interview he throws a phone at somebody in his hotel room, you know, because he's angry at him. You know, we're not talking some little cell phone. We're talking the hotel, you know, desk table phone. You know, the whole phone, not just the receiver. But yeah, it's, you know, so maybe that plays like, yeah, we want to get Russell Crowe for this movie. He's crazy. We need a crazy guy. Apparently he needed the money. Wow. You know, wow. I just can't believe he was in this movie. All right. So overall, shock of thumbs down for Unhinged. You know, just wait till it's on standard TV or you catch it in your own Netflix account or Amazon or whatever, HBO, Cinemax or whatever, when this starts showing. It'll probably show up on TNT eventually, and you can just watch it there and be, you know, taken back at why Russell Crowe made this movie to begin with, just like I was watching it. But you don't want to spend any of your money or risk your safety to see it at theaters. All right. Thank you so much. This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man here in Hawaii, bringing you a shock of thumbs down for Unhinged, unfortunately. All right. Thank you so much and aloha.